Well, you know, I just got out of high school. We've been making films with them for, you know, 2 or 3 years now, videos. And it just got to the point where, you know, graduating became surreal. I knew it had to come to an end. We had a blast on everything we did, but it had to come to an end. So I started at the Art Institute in October. And, you know, from May, you know, to October, that's a long time. And I didn't want to, you know, be out of the loop on the filmmaking and stuff like that. So I wanted a new project. I wanted something to do. But I didn't know exactly what that project was going to be. And one day, my friend Gabriel Graham, who's also the assistant director of DeadLine, came to me and wanted to make a video. He said, let's make a project. I said, all right, because I'm always up for making a, you know, a good, you know, new project. He said, why don't we make a music video? He said, okay. And originally we were going to make a music video about Star Wars versus Harry Potter, because me and him have this little friendly feud going on about, you know, what's better, Harry Potter or Star Wars. And of course, Harry Potter. Everybody knows. That's just, it's an iconic saga. But anyway, we sat down at Johnny's Pizza one afternoon, me, Colton Hennon, and Gabriel. Colton Hennon's also a member of the crew of DeadLine. And we realized that, because I've known about this, the Rome International Film Festival, for a while now. And I just recently had a meeting with a few people of the board of the Rome International Film Festival, and I was like, this is something I should get involved in, because I know they have a student festival, a student competition. And I told Gabriel and Colton, I was like, you know, there's this thing, the Rome International Film Festival, there's a student competition. I said, why don't we do this and enter that and, you know, make it really good? So we were like, yeah, man, that's awesome. That sounds really cool. And so the idea of DeadLine was born. It was an idea that I had a while back. You know, I had been wanting to produce it sort of because we wanted it to be sort of, had to be a 5-minute limit. We wanted it to be kind of have a punchline to it, have to be like kind of a joke and be cool to watch. And we had to, you know, write the script, the screenplay with what we had to work with. And as far as the actor who we would get to play the main character of DeadLine, we thought about it. We were like, you know, who has the ability to run a lot, who has the ability to jump and do crazy stuff, and also who can drive really well. And all of a sudden, everybody was like, yeah, Austin Terry. And we just was like, of course, Austin Terry. So we had the meeting that day, and then a couple days later, we met with Austin Terry, me and Gabriel at Chili's, and we talked about it and showed him a few concept ideas we had about the film, and he was all on board with it, all on board. And we just kind of sat down, planned the screenplay, and a shot list, and that sort of thing, and kind of a basic mode of how we were going to get it done, and it just all sort of flowed. But, you know, we got it done. We tried. We think it looks amazing. We're all very pleased with it. And this is what we have.
All right, this is Gabriel. I'm the assistant director for DeadLine, and we are about to go take our very first shot.
Well, working with Austin has really been a pleasure. I mean, he's definitely one of the most focused people I know whenever it comes to doing what he wants to do, and he's a great filmmaker. You know, he makes an awesome director, and just the way that he ran this whole project was really great. And I knew it'd be like that. That's why I wanted to work with him from the get-go. You know, he's definitely, if I want to make a movie, you know, I want to make it with him. But overall, I mean, he's just so professional about everything and trying to get everything done the way it is. He's probably the only person on the entire project that never got sidetracked. The whole time that we're out there filming, I mean, we had days where we were out there filming for, you know, 12 hours, and, you know, he was as focused as a laser beam the whole time, and it was just really a great experience to get to work with somebody like that. And of course, the rest of the crew, Austin Terry, our lead actor, was absolutely phenomenal. The way that he cooperated with, you know, what me and Austin wanted to do with the film and our vision for what we wanted it to be. I think there's nobody else that could have really captured our vision of Deadline like Austin Terry did. He took it and he personified everything that we needed for the film. And the rest of the crew was great too. Josh and Colton, you know, put in a lot of effort. And they were there, and it was overall, it was a great experience, and I'm, you know, really glad I did it.
Where I come from isn't all that great. The most fun part about filming this was no doubt not even filming this. Screwing around was so much fun throughout this entire film. Other than that, I mean, filming itself was fun as well, though. It was just, you know, you had to get more serious, more into it, which was definitely fun, because, I mean, my knowledge of film and stuff like that is zero. I'm not very good at it, but when it came down to picking stuff up, carrying it, and, you know, giving assistance to Austin or Dabriel, just throughout the entire thing was a ton of fun. I really enjoyed it.
It was fun. It was hilarious. Austin, well, you had to use Austin Terry's big work truck to get down to the creek and everything, and on the way back up, we had a little trouble, and Austin's brother almost didn't get up the hill good enough, and we started rolling back because it was a stick, and Austin screamed like a little girl, about fell out, and it was hilarious.
Oh, you suck. You ain't gonna throw us out, go! Chris.
We went to Wendy's, started out going to Wendy's. We watched this YouTube video, it was describing how to make a dolly. And we were like, okay. So then from Wendy's, it just turned into this like 6-hour day of nothing but going to Home Depot, Ace Hardware, back to Home Depot, to Kmart, to Skate Life for whatever reason, and then back to Home Depot, to Ace Hardware, and then to Austin's house. All of this while I'm driving. So much gas.
The day that we filmed on Broad Street, it's probably our longest day filming. And a lot of the ideas that we used for that scene was really made up on the spot. And while we were getting ready to film the scene in Opera Alley, we ran across a guy that I know from going to school at Rome. And we decided that we'd get him to play the hobo. And we tried. And he was awful.
We're here today to destroy something that caused us great grief in the making of the movie.
Now move your hand.
It was so hard to adjust. It took you about 5 minutes just to change the time on it. And then you had to get the time perfectly right. And then we would usually mess up, and then we'd have to reset the watch all over again. I made a flamethrower, and we're going to melt the watch that we hate so much.
Tell us a little bit about your flamethrower. How did you build it? What was the process?
Really easy. Just went and bought it. Took some duct tape and duct tape some Q-tips on the end right here, and then you light these two. It's a big flame that comes up right here, and you shoot. That's gas right there. That's gas.
Yeah! I got a gas.
Oh my god. I think the watch is devil. It's like evil because it's still showing the date and time. Chris, I think we should give it a little bit more.
Let's do it.
Let's Chris. Let's make sure this thing goes to hell.